Hello, everyone. Welcome to The Storyist. Often we judge people, especially women, by the way they dress, not knowing their story behind. Today, I will tell you a story about an office manager who made his assistant wear a miniskirt and makeup to look presentable. A few days later, he regrets judging the girl by the way she dresses. Stick until the end of the video to find out what happened. Kara is a very beautiful young lady. She is loved by many. And she is not only a bearer of an angelic face, she is also a bright and very nice woman. She lives in a small neighborhood where everybody knows everyone else. Since she was a little girl, everyone in the neighborhood has been captivated by her beauty. A lot of people in her neighborhood love to call her the belle of their town, as she resembles Belle's brunette hair, and she loves to read books. The only difference between her and the famous fairy tale character is that she grew up in a very poor household. Her parents are both old people now, and her younger siblings are in school. So she has no other choice but to work hard for her siblings' education. At a young age, Kara started to do laundry for her neighbors. Sometimes she would clean houses of her rich neighbors too, or babysit kids in their town. Since everyone knew her as the polite girl, it was not very hard for her to find jobs from her neighbors. But then, her siblings were growing up, and she had to earn more money. So she decided to take a better-paying job, such as being a waitress in a diner or cleaning bathhouses during the night. She worked double shifts, too, so she could provide enough for her three siblings attending school. During this phase of Kara's life, everything was going fine so far. Her mother and father would help with the household expenses by selling goods. Her mother's specialties used to be famous in their neighborhood, and everyone would buy their breakfast or even lunch from their small store. So far, things were going great for Kara's family, until one tragic incident happened. One day, while Kara is on her way home from the bathhouse she is working in, she sees a silhouette of blinding ambulance lights positioned at the front of her house. The moment she sees this from afar, she runs as fast as she can to reach the vehicle on time. She peeps inside and sees her mother lying on the ambulance bed. She asks her father and her siblings about what happened and learns that her mother suffered a stroke. She immediately gets inside the car with her family. Kara spends days inside the hospital caring for her mother. Her father still has to make ends meet so they can pay the hospital bills, and her siblings must continue their studies. So she is the one to compromise and give up her regular jobs to take care of her mother. After a few days, her mother heals and regains her strength, but the doctor says she might not be strong enough to continue cooking for business. Because of that, Kara's family lost another source of income. This is the moment when she remembers that one of her friends in the city is offering her a secretarial job that doesn't need a long educational background. She thinks she might not be able to do it, but it pays well, and it can help their family pay for the hospital bills. So the next morning, she immediately leaves their town and tries her luck in the city. She tells her childhood friend in the city, whom she grew up with, that she will be staying with her. This friend was the one who told her about the job opening. She was her best friend, too. But she pursued life in the city right after she graduated high school. This is the first time in years that she will ever see her again. Kara meets her friend in the city, and the two reconnect. Her friend tells her all about the job so she can pass the interview. When the day of the interview comes, Kara is nothing but nervous. She feels her sweat falling down her entire body. It is her first time attending a corporate interview, and she feels like she will not pass it. But thinking about her family's current situation, she gathers all her energy and courage to face the interviewer. A few moments later, a man in a black suit and tie comes in. He does not even look at her. He just starts directly on the interview. After a few moments in the interview, Kara feels like she is somehow acing it, as she can answer all the questions being thrown at her. But then, when the interviewer gets up to shake her hand, he notices Kara's outfit. She is wearing a simple long-sleeved polo shirt over a pair of black pants. She is also wearing flats rather than heels. The interviewer's look suddenly changes to disappointment.
"What on earth are you wearing?" the interviewer harshly asks.
Kara is surprised to see the sudden shift in the man's voice. "I'm sorry, is there anything wrong with my clothes?" Kara politely asks in reply. The interviewer shoots her a sharp look from head down to her toe.
"Yes, it looks disgusting. When you show up at work tomorrow, it's either you wear a mini skirt and makeup or you're out on your first day,"
the man harshly says to Kara. She almost cries hearing these words before she even starts her new job. But she knows she has to be tough for her family. When Kara gets home, she doesn't know how to get that office outfit her new boss is demanding from her. All she has are pants and corporate tops, but no skirts. She has to buy new skirts, but she hasn't received any salary yet, as she is just about to start. So she has no money at all. She sobs in frustration, trying to think of what to do. Morning comes and she enters her new office. Her boss sees her and instead of greeting her good morning, the man looks at her from head to toe. She is wearing the same style of polo top from yesterday, and she is wearing proper black pants and flat shoes.
"Did I not tell you to dress nicely?" the boss asks in a harsh tone.
Kara apologizes immediately, but her boss is quick to dismiss her.
"If you can't dress nicely, then I can't trust you with my clients," the boss exclaims, and tells Kara to leave.
Kara is very devastated to lose her first job in the city, just her first day of showing up for it. Her boss, on the other hand, sees it like nothing, and he promptly hires another secretary who dresses in short skirts, puts full-on makeup, and walks in silhouettes. The boss starts enjoying the company of his new secretary. She looks so pretty that he is almost always distracted at work. But he feels like everything is worth it, because such a face and body can surely attract and sign deals with more clients. Then, his secretary's time to do her first presentation comes. The boss is looking highly at his secretary, confident that she is going to give a superb presentation. However, on the day itself, the secretary buckles and stutters, and turns out she doesn't know anything about her presentation after all. The boss is very disappointed, regretting his choice. Then, before they leave, a competitor group comes with a familiar face. Kara is the secretary of the competitor group, and she will be presenting. The boss decides to stay a while, thinking that if his secretary messed up, he is sure Kara will as well. But then, Kara starts presenting, and she articulates every topic thoroughly. The clients are very impressed, commending Kara for her superb presentation skills and commending her new boss for choosing such a skilled secretary. He looks at Kara, and she smiles at him. When he takes a glance at her outfit, she is wearing the same simple clothes she was wearing inside his office before. He shakes his head, thinking how Kara's new boss accepted her with that kind of office attire. The clients clap their hands on Kara and her boss, and they give the deal to the team. Before everyone leaves, the boss approaches Kara's new boss, asking him why he had decided to hire Kara despite the way she dresses.
"Do you want to know one key to a successful business?"
the new boss starts. Kara's former boss is all ears, eager to hear what the person who grabbed his client is about to say.
"Never judge a book by its cover,"
Kara's new boss continues and smiles at him. The new boss then thanks Kara for her efforts and commends her for her skills. The man who first had Kara regrets his choice up to this day. That's all for today. We hope you enjoyed that video, and we'll see you in the next.